Let's take it out on the road for a ride and test how quick it goes, and then we'll talk about how it feels. We opted to go for the numbers we got from our GPS speed test over the Metacycle's reading itself. So whatever speed we end up with in between the GPS and the odometer is a sweet spot we'll go by. GPS may be a bit on the latent side, while the odometer will most likely be a certain percentage optimistic over the true speed. Also, sorry, but the Metacycle odometer was hardly visible in the sun, so I'll be placing the reading on the screen in post-edit. So, the Metacycle should be doing 0 to 60 in about 8 to 9 seconds, not too far from what Sondors advertised, but it doesn't. On takeoff, you start noticing around the 40 miles per hour mark or so that the initial torque boost starts to die out, and while it continues accelerating, it hauls much slower from that point on. So, just as most electric vehicles, there's some software limitation at play on the motor performance. By the time you reach 60 miles per hour, after it draws out through the high 50s, it's already been past 8 to 9 seconds onto more like over 10 seconds. Now, the 0 to 60 test definitely yielded different outcomes for me than from the owner. While he reliably got 10 to 11 seconds over enough tests, I got more like 16. He's around 150 pounds and I'm around 250 pounds, so there's a whole 100 pound difference at play here. If Sondors had never promised 0 to 60 in 6 seconds, then I would be fine with the average quickness of the Metacycle. But they did, and that is their mistake.